4312.
Page 37.
Thank you.
I'll move 201,900.
I'll second that.
Page 97.
Yeah, I know.
The total for the section is on page 99.
You want to go to 90?
It's 40, 4930.
Let's go further.
Oh, 4930.
Reconstruction should be 440.
440,930.
Yeah.
Second that.
Tim seconded it.
Well, I was seconding the other page, but I can second that for you.
This will work just as well.
Now, we'll let you lead out.
Not a commitment.
Questions?
So the first question, A, is hired equipment summer, please explain the jump. That's the result of hiring a contractor to do beach raking at Sun Valley.
Right.
And that was how much of the 15? It's like, I believe it was $12,000.
Is that about what we've historically spent on beach raking at Sun Valley?
No.
Higher or lower?
Higher.
Higher.
We used to tap on to the state of New Hampshire's contract for that service.
Yeah.
And we're no longer able to do that, so now we have to do it on our own.
Did it go off a bid?
No. I was very fortunate to find one contractor in the whole region of New England to find that would be willing to do it for that amount. There is no bid. There was no...
Not a lot of guys doing this.
No. In fact, he had to buy a specific piece of equipment to do that.
So happy, you know, you're getting good price if nobody bid.
It was the only price.
Oh.
If you didn't put it out the bid, how do you...
Because I contacted a number of places to find out if the... I contacted the manufacturer of the beach rakes and asked them who they sell them to. I went online, I Googled in, you know, the companies that do that. There's only one company that sells them in this region. And I called him up, and he said that nobody's doing it in this area for a contractor, but he said you might want to call this guy here and check with him, and I did.
Who does the Rye beaches, or Northampton beaches, or Portsmouth beach, or whatever?
Those are state beaches.
Are they all state?
I don't believe the town does any.
No, you mean the individual towns?
The individual towns.
No further comments on that?
Thank you.
Or on that page from...
All right.
Sidewalks and curbs.
We're still on this page. Maybe you want to ask Eileen if there's anybody got any questions on this page?
Keith is still going through it.
Now we're going to the next page.
What's happened is we've already covered some of these things, so we can go quickly.
I would like to stay on that subject if you want to do that.
I would rather go through the questions.
Okay.
With Keith, have him add anything to it in his presentation, and then have all of you ask your questions instead of breaking it up. Because the other way...
Go to the president.
That's...
So sidewalks and...
Presiding officer.
Sidewalks and curbs, zero through September 2014. As I explained earlier, that's one of those expenses that I'm withholding because of the overall state of the budget at this point in time.
So there is still a possibility, if we do not get hit with any snow, that we may see this expenditure.
Yes, and what I'll do is, what I've done with Mike Switzer in the past is, I get POs ready to go, like, right after Christmas. And then, assuming that...
Before the first of the year.
Before the first of the year. The problem with this specific account, what I really want to do, what I've been hoping to do, is to do sealing of all the concrete sidewalks around town. And we put that out to bid to see what response. We didn't get any contractors, and we did a lot of advertising to do that work. So I'm even thinking about having our guys come in and do it on the weekends and do it on overtime to get it done. But it would come out of that $26,000.
Otherwise, we're going to lose years in our sidewalks.
Absolutely.
You have the next 5 or 10 sidewalks identified as to which ones you...
Yeah. Well, the Hampton Beach is the one I want to do, you know, as a priority, because those are the ones that were just built recently. Try to get them done as soon as possible after the initial construction of them.
Hampton Beach.
Side streets.
Side streets.
Yeah, yeah, side streets.
Okay.
Island Ave.
Thank you.
Okay. Hired equipment winter, see an increase. That's just what I was saying. We have two new routes by private contractors. Does the salt shed carry only the salt, or is some form of mixing with sand occur? The shed itself only carries salt. But we do mixing outside of the shed, but we don't contaminate the inside with sand.
Shed contains your salt.
Right, and we typically go with an 80-20% mixture, 80% sand and 20% salt. Do you have a suggestion or a plan to reduce streetlight costs? That's another thing that I've talked about before. I think there is an opportunity to save a considerable amount of money with streetlights, but that would be involving a political decision to start removing streetlights around town.
it's a big rider at $200,000 plus, and I don't know, maybe go to Argonne or...
LEDs.
You know, LEDs.
The problem with that, Jerry, I've been through this before. They have a 20-year lifespan for what their cost is. So if you ask them to change, say the light is 15 years old, and you ask them to go to, say, high-pressure sodium or some of this new technology, LEDs. You have to pay the undepreciated value of that light from the year 15 to 20. So it's not a real true savings. It's very complicated. I've looked at this. I've been through this before. The only real way to do it isn't to just switch from one technology to another, is the actual reduction in streetlights, and that is a political issue.
It's a safety issue. Quite simple.
I wonder what the other towns
are. I've noticed the number of towns that have gotten grants to upgrade their street lighting. Have you looked into those?
Yes. Durham's done that. My good friend is the public works director in Durham. And they did that very thing, and there has been some money in the past. I'm not aware of any program right now to do that. That was a public service company in New Hampshire program. I've talked to Unitil about that handles our street lights. In fact, I was talking to them today. There's no incentive program to do that from Unitil at this stage.
How could there be no incentive for that? Being an electrical contractor, we have a huge incentive to install LED lighting in any new construction, and they write it off. You got a huge savings on that. How can there not be that for street lighting? I don't agree with that.
I've looked into it. I had a contractor from Hampton Falls call me up and say, oh, we've got a plan. We can save the town hundreds of thousands of dollars on street lighting costs. And I said, I'll come down, meet with you. I went down, and I said, can you guarantee these savings? No, we can't. I called Unitil. I said, is this company legit? They says, we can't comment on that, but be wary of the situation, what you're getting yourself into. So if you know of a program, please let me know. Email me, yes. And I'll follow up on it.
So
please let me know, and I'll be more than happy to look into it.
Like I said, being an electrical contractor town, we get huge rebates.
I know you can for certain.
And that's for commercial, residential.
Right.
It doesn't matter what we're doing.
We got for the Church Street pump station. We got a huge subsidy for that because of the energy saving conservation. We're looking out for these things. What I'm trying to tell you is that I contacted Unitil to ask them specific for municipal lighting, not for private or pumps or whatever. And the answer is there is nothing in place right now.
I'll ask them.
It's a big nut, though.
Moving on.
Storm drainage maintenance goes back to just withholding that work at the time being. We're still doing work. We placed the culverts on, what was it? Cusack Road. Thank you. Cusack Road. But again, that's one of those accounts that is non-essential that we've been holding off just because of the overall state of the budget. Green maintenance. That does it for that section.
Actually, that lighting question is a different section. Mm-hmm. The next section.
Yeah. Well, then we won't have to ask it in that
one. No, you won't.
We can't answer.
Okay, going back to the beginning here. And, Jerry, I hate to skip over you, but...
No, it's okay.
I think you've been taken care of. Okay. Joe, are you good?
Is there... No, I got a few. Is there any, I mean, we've been in the default budget a few years now. Is there anything that's going to be done with Fairfield, Ruth, and Belmont? I mean, that's been sitting there for years.
As it stands right now, There is a warrant article proposed for that, taking the money from our highway block grant from the gasoline tax revenue to apply that to do that road. So it's going to be presented to the selectmen Monday night for their consideration to support that article.
Okay, and hired equipment, summer help. It says rental of equipment not available. We don't have this equipment in our stock. Why are we spending, you're saying 12K for Sunnyvale, but we don't have, why are we renting equipment? I don't understand that.
That's what I was just talking about. That's where that beach raking comes up.
Right. So that's 12, but you're asking 15, so where's the other three?
There's times that we would need a low bed to haul a loader to a repair facility.
I understand. Okay.
Right. Or yep. Even a tow truck, if we need a tow truck or something like that.
Yeah. The sidewalk repairs. North side of town, Route 1, those sidewalks have been done and they're falling apart. I mean, I hear you want to seal, you know, the beach, and it seems like everything's driven to the beach. We want to take care of the beach, but the rest side of town, you walk them, you can't.
Now, the reason I want to, the only reason that I've identified the beach for that work is that if you don't seal a concrete site within a certain period of time,
correct,
it's going to start scaling.
So are you asking the planning board to no more concrete sidewalks, stay to a hot top instead?
We won't approve any concrete sidewalks. I won't. In fact, that was an issue with the selectmen, and I convinced them they thought that concrete sidewalks are great. They're placed down
they're
at the
great,
end of... when a Conant Road, they wanted to put a concrete, that new
Ross
condo, they
yeah,
wanted to
right
put a concrete, they require the asphalt.
Okay.
In New England, that's the best thing to do.
Okay, I'm all set.
Okay.
I was at a meeting last Saturday at Peterborough where the town of Hollis said they received the grant to do an upgrade on their streetlights. I'll pull up the website and send it to you.
Sure, I'd be. If yep anybody has any information, I'll definitely will follow up on it. I appreciate
same thing,
that
City
information.
City of Manchester's mm-hmm got some grant money for it as
yep
well.
Yeah.
That's it.
I have a couple of things. My first question is on page 98.
98?
Yes. Tree maintenance, including cemeteries.
For this last year.
Mm. I know, and I thought we were going to put this back into cemeteries for whatever it is they spent. Mm-hmm. Is this the trees that are coming down, the pine trees that are coming down?
They have their, it's in their budget too.
Right.
In the cemetery's budget.
That was raised
that was
last
a request
year
from the town manager to put that money in there. I do know that they're looking at, the town manager has proposed a warrant article to take down the pine trees at the Pine Grove Cemetery. But I have had to this situation, especially with Pine Grove, where the residents right next door has been nervous about the trees falling onto their house. So just out of default and safety, we had to use our financial resources to go in there because the cemetery said they didn't have any money for that purpose at the time. So this is more of a town manager directive to me to put money in there to be able to maintain the cemeteries. I don't totally understand that logic, but that's...
Are you insured to do this in the cemeteries?
The contractor is
insured. We hire a contractor.
We don't do it ourselves.
So you hired out as being a contractor?
Right.
Yeah. We do 3-year bids for tree removal. The last two bids have been won by Urban Tree Service, and that's who we contract with. We have some set prices for certain things. Other things we have to get an individual estimate for.
All right, yeah, because that's one question I've had is people have talked about the fact that somebody could drop a tree on.
No, I'm talking
right
about the
gravestone. Our guys with our chainsaws really just try and stick with the ones that are already in the road, fallen in the road, I should say, emergency ones.
35.
My next one is
tree service and cemetery.
Again on page, I'm going off of 98 and highways and maintenance. Resurface patch and crack sealing. Is this something we're we have a plan for, or is this like as we go along?
The plan that we have, and you might have seen around town, and we're trying to catch up on it right now, where our highway general foreman will go out and identify deficient portions of roadways, and then he'll mark them out, focus on the main arterial roads, and we'll grind them down an inch, and then we'll have a follow-up crew come in, and they'll put an inch of new pavement on there. So the plan is based on the use of the road. The arterial road is what we're focusing on now.
There's no tree service on the cemetery budget this year.
No, this year. It was last year.
So, I mean, it's...
Anything else, Brian?
And my last one is, I'm going to follow up on what someone brought up earlier. The road painting, the contracts, are these put out to bid?
Yes. Every 3 years.
Every 3 years? And that's all I have. Thank you.
Yep.
Okay. Got a few. I'm just going to fire through them. Excuse me. On the tree removal, I realize that there are times they come down. I don't like seeing them in two places in the budget.
They're not in cemeteries.
There's nothing in cemeteries?
No. Right.
Okay.
Which it was last year.
But it's being contracted from both ends. I mean, it's being contracted out. We're not actually doing it.
Correct.
So I guess I'd wonder why it wouldn't be under the cemeteries to take care of their trees, and it gets confusing.
Yeah.
Okay. As long just as it's not in both places. I'm sorry?
Town-wide, not just cemeteries. Town-wide, including cemeteries.
Yeah, it is town-wide, including cemeteries. So it's so we'll look to see none of that coming out of cemeteries. Out of any line, right? It's one-stop shopping.
It is.
Yeah.
All right. Much like we took legal out of our budget. It comes out of the legal budget should we need legal. It's all coming out of here. All right. There's a couple of things here that really disturb me, Keith, that have nothing to do with you and probably in a mindset bother you as much as it bothers me. Every year we sit here and we budget for certain amounts, only to not even touch those amounts or do that work intended. And this year, I have listened to a lot of complaints about our sidewalks, about our roads, and we continue to build money in that never has a prayer of getting spent because it's held back till the end of the year. My father was DPW, you know that. You all know that. I understand how difficult this is because we can't predict Mother Nature. And it makes it tough. But when we roll year after year after year, doing the same things to the same items, we built very expensive sidewalks down the beach. They're relatively new, but they're going to fall apart if we don't find a way to seal them. And every year I say, I'll give you the money there, but please, let me see something done on them. And every year it falls victim. So I'm almost to the point of saying, let them go as far as they can. There's no sense in funding that. You're never going to see it.
Please don't get to that point, really, because that wouldn't be a wise investment on the part of the town. Someone made a decision to go with concrete sidewalks years ago, well before my time. I wouldn't have made that same decision because I don't believe in concrete sidewalks in New England when you have the salt. The salting is what's going to deteriorate the sidewalks. But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't maintain them properly because once that top film off that sidewalk deteriorates and then it starts scaling, the deterioration is going to accelerate over time, and then it's going to become a tripping hazard on the side roads, and then it's a liability to the town. I really want to do it. Like I said, we put it out to bid, hopefully to get a bid to do it, and no one bids. So I've come up with a game plan to do it next year. And
I mean, do we have to send all of this out? I'm hearing bid a lot. Do we have to send all this out to bid because we're short on manpower?
We are very short on manpower. It's not unusual throughout this year that we've had two people on the highway crew between absences and everybody on trash and recycling pickup. We and Frank Swift will tell you, we've had lucky to have two people.
I mean, when I go down a road, and I can pick anyone out right now, and I see the washouts on the shoulders. And you go by a couple of months later, and now those washouts, the pavement that's starting to break up. And a lot of these areas that weren't maintained, as the plows go by, are going to make a supreme mess out of them as they go along. Where were the road crews to put the fill in? And I don't, maybe I'm not using the right words. Yes. To rebuild, usually it's a road crew that right. goes out and fills those cavities. And it doesn't keep roads totally from deteriorating, but it does stop some of what I'm projecting out there. I don't see that going on.
I put in the budget. My proposed budget included two people for the highway crew to help get caught up on our infrastructure needs in this town. And it was, you know, rejected from the budget. That I did not get the support on that. And I understand the way things are with the default budget, so I'm not whining.
But not to interrupt you, this committee is not here to make a default budget. We're here to make a budget to hear what we need to cure some of these things. Every time we say we're going to put it out to bid, when you put things out to bid, a contractor pays his people and then he makes a profit on top of that. So I'm not a keen proponent of putting everything out to bid. When we're talking about EPW, road crews, a town this size, a department this big, and we don't have two people to go out and fill the cavities. That's what I'm talking about.
We do.
Till we get
we
to
have,
November?
Yeah, well, we do, but we have 77 miles of road.
Then I would say that two people is not enough.
Right.
That's exactly why I proposed, if you look in there, I proposed two additional people, not a crew of five or seven or whatever, to try to give us the manpower to get caught up on some of this work that desperately needs to be done around town.
And did you have a price tag on those two individuals?
Yes, it's in there. So I don't have it off the top of my head, but it was in the original budget request that
it
I
would only
be
the labor cost. It would
$46,000. That was $46,000, but that was just for about 7 months, and that did not include the benefits, which would have come out of Christie's budget.
Now, they're not going to be used for trash detail, are they?
The only time they would be used is if they were covering for someone that's out absent or something like that.
That's not the answer I would hope for. Okay? I'm looking for dedicated people for road work in this town.
After the seafood festival, we went from, when the salt waste collection routes shifted, we went from two people a normal day to having five. That's when you saw all of a sudden where this milling machine come from. All this white paint appeared around town magically. The leprechaun of Frank Swift and Chris Jacobs went around and painted all this stuff. Then you saw a ton of milling, mm-hmm. and then right behind that, and it was a game, but we knew we were on a deadline until the weather turned. And now you see miraculously in the last 2 weeks, or last week, as the weather's turned, nothing. Now if we get a 3 or 4 day break and it goes to above 55, we'll probably go back and mill more. We're having to mill and patch because we don't have paving money. And we're only milling and patching because after September. You mentioned the roadside grader. I've got that box that'll hang on the back end of the truck where I can dish off grading material to put in shoulders. We haven't used it in 3 years. I have a paint machine for painting crosswalks. I don't have the labor to paint crosswalks. Okay, so I haven't used that particular machine. I pray that someday I'll have the labor. That's why it didn't appear in the auction. So we have some equipment, but we don't have the labor.
I mean, if I were you, I would be coming in here singing to us, this is what you need. I mean, I watched lines being painted.
But we're trying to work with everybody. We're trying to work with the Board of Selectmen and all 16 members of the Budget Committee and taxpayers. We realize it's a balancing act. So we're here to inform, mm-hmm. but there has to be, we'll inform, but I guess there has to be a groundswell of people that want to do this. from every group.
Eileen, all we can do is propose it, and I did propose it. I proposed the manpower. That's all I can do. I don't know what else I can do at this point.
I'm not.
You see it there.
Out strongly, and I apologize. This is not a negative attack on what
I'm not taking it.
What I'm saying is that for the number, there's nowhere that I've gone that somebody has not said something about the things I've just brought up.
Yep.
Absolutely. Right? And as public works director, I hear it all the time.
Things that I've seen myself. I've seen the lines being painted down Ann's Lane. All right. And 2 months later, they're being filled in when the lines have almost faded and it's screaming manpower. And yes, the weather does close in. I'm sorry if you wait to address your roads and your streets till you get to, you know, October. It's going to happen more times than not that you're not going to get it done. And our job's here. We want to give you money to work with. We want to give you the money you need. But at the end of the day, not only us, but the taxpayers want to see that those things were done.
Right. And, okay? And let me just clarify your question to me on those two additional employees. I didn't mean to say that those employees on top of the other employees that are doing trash would be required to do trash, but I can't guarantee if we hire A and B that they're going to someday fill in for D and E because they're out for the day. But having an extra two people would add to the overall crew, so we would always have two people extra than what we have now.
If you didn't have them, you would have to address the trash situation as it is right now, as you addressed it all year and the year before and the year before. I think woefully we are way beyond what needs to be done in roads and drains. So to say, if I considered building back into the budget that amount of money for those two people, I guess I would want some confidence that that's where they're going and no more to trash and recycling. If we don't put the money in there, you still have the status quo of what you had.
I could give you that assurance. Like I said, under the worst case scenario when we've had in the summer, when I talked about hearing that we only had two people in highway, that was in addition to a full complement of people on solid waste pickup and recycling pickup. Mm-hmm. So if we got the extra two people, we would then have four people, which make up a crew. Right now, two people can't do a crew of work because you got to have someone watching the other's back and whatever. Two people don't work very well putting hot top down. Mm-hmm. You got to have a crew of at least three and preferably four.
What would be the fringes on those two people, Christy? Do you know offhand?
Well, that would be part-time positions, wouldn't it?
No, that no. Would, we would suggest that full those time. Would be
full-time.
Yeah, it goes up from
the health insurance is right around 23
for each.
For health insurance. Really good.
And then probably another 15,000 for the extras, give or take.
I would think 35 each.
All right. Small I'm good on that. Michael, thank you.
Keep moving.
Keith. Milling and patching. I know it's not. I've seen you do it on Winnicott Road. I was just congratulating Pete tonight that, you know, it's the next best thing to resurface in the whole road. But at least if you mill and patch it, and if you covered it with that black stuff that people put on their driveway, you'd never know the difference. You'd think it was a new road, more or less. The one thing I want to make sure that is not misunderstood. On Lafayette Road, there were concrete sidewalks, correct?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right. And also on High Street. Okay.
They're gone.
They're gone?
No, they're still there, but they're gone.
Oh, well, no, but there was a comment about that somebody made about the. It seems like all of it goes to the beach. And since all the side of the bench is from the beach, I just want to mention that that's not really true, Joe. I want to stick up for the beach a little bit, okay? So I'm sure if you had the money, you'd put some of that sealer on the ones uptown as well.
No, I wouldn't.
It's too late.
And I'll tell you why. Once it starts scaling, the sealer is relatively ineffective. Okay. You have to get it while the surface is in good condition, that's when you need to do the sealing. Once it starts scaling, it just absorbs down, it just starts chalking, and that's the main reason why I want to do
the... So it's too late to do that uptown, and that's the only reason they don't spend the money uptown, Joe. So spend it down at the beach. Okay, thank you very much. Mr. Jones.
It makes perfect sense that you wouldn't want to seal anything unless you were already, basically, you got virgin concrete. That's when you seal it.
I'm not saying it's not when you've lost all that, effective. It's better than nothing to seal even those, but it's not cost-effective to do it because it doesn't hold up.
What you end up sealing is a rough surface, which the sealer comes off more quickly anyway.
Yeah, well, it sucks right down into the asphalt, the concrete.
The... $10,000 increase under 441 on page 97 for those following the book.
Page
97 for those following the book. Suffix is 441.
Mm-hmm.
A $10,000 increase.
Yeah.
And from what I understand from your earlier statement by, I think, Jerry's question, that $10,000 increase is the result of needing to rake the beach, is the same.
Sun Valley.
Okay.
Sun Valley. Now, Sun Valley is that which is on the south side of the Hampton River, right? Harbor, which is really, most people think of as Seabrook, but it's actually a little patch there.
Yeah. Right.
So $10,000 to do that. Previous years.
$12,000.
That line only shows a $10,000 increase.
But it's,
you must have saved $2,000 somewhere else, I guess.
No, it was, all I can tell you is it's $12,000. I negotiated the contract for that work.
Well, the budget for this year is $5,000, and you're proposing $15,000. That's a $10,000 difference. Okay. So that's the $10,000 that I'm coming up with in my mind.
Yeah.
That's the default budget.
Do you need more?
That's the default
budget. No, you're right, Tim.
It's the default budget.
No, I know. This operating budget.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a $10,000 increase over this operating budget.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And all of that, I mean, the previous years that raking was not done or was done by some other cheaper means or what?
We had a deal with the state. The state would have, they would hire a contractor and use their own rakes. Mm-hmm. And so we had a deal. It was like a quid pro thing that they would do it, and we wouldn't have to pay for the rake. We would just pay the contractor's time. But that's been eliminated.
And do you know what the motivation was for that elimination?
Politics.
Could you elaborate?
No.
Okay. So the state is continuing to contract to rake Seabrook Beach, but as soon as it hits the Hampton-Seabrook line, it stops now? Is that what I'm
saying?
Okay. And before, we asked them to continue on for that little bit of space on Hampton that's there, and we give them a little extra money to do that. It's kind of like being a good neighbor. We're asking them to do that, right? We pay them for their cost.
On the, up by, what's it called? That little section.
White Speech.
What's it called?
No, I thought we were talking about the spot just over the...
Sun Valley.
Right.
Yeah, so Palm Beach, we think. The state doesn't do
Seabrook. Right. Town of Seabrook.
They have their
Seabrook.
Own person.
But there is a little section by Boston Ave, I guess it is, in that area that's owned by the town that the state does as another quid pro thing that we have with
But this $10,000 increase, just to go back to my original question, this $10,000 increase is about raking the beach.
Right.
Correct.
And the beach we're talking about is?
Sun Valley.
Sun Valley. Yeah. Which is that which is located south of the Hampton River.
Yes.
Okay. And that's just a little space that's town-owned
yes.
beach.
Yes.
Okay. And in previous years, the state, when it does its raking of the Seabrook Beach, Seabrook does its own.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we approached Seabrook to see if they would do ours, and we would pay them for it, and they said absolutely not.
How much does a rake
cost? Do they have a rake?
Yes.
Did they do it previous years?
No.
State had always done it.
State had always done it.
Okay. So maybe we need to have a better liaison with town of Seabrook to be more cooperative. I don't know.
Or the state.
Or the state.
I think it makes more sense for Seabrook to do it since they're already there with their rake, you know. But whatever, I mean, that's just a thought.
That's a good thought, though. It is.
Mm-hmm. We tried.
We tried that.
I see. Well, we should keep trying because it's just a good neighborliness kind of thing.
What is Seabrook's reason for not wanting to do it?
I wasn't involved with those negotiations. The town manager is directly involved with the town manager of Seabrook on that.
And Fred tried to do it.
Well, he was.
I know the answer was no.
Fred was the former town manager of Seabrook.
Okay.
Yes.
So, he still didn't get it.
I guess he should know who to talk to.
You got the picture.
Gentlemen, we're hitting the witching hour here.
But, you know, for the state rep.
Just to continue.
This is a good one. We don't get our share of meals and rooms tax.
Well, that's a separate topic.
So what I'm saying is, how's about...
Okay, we're way off. Let's get back on the questions, okay?
Storm drainage. You know, I'm really concerned that I'm going to miss my opportunity to speak about the Gristmill Dam. So if this is the spot, let me know. If not, I'll just move on.
There is no spot in my budget for the discussion.
Really?
It's a Warren article. Yeah.
It was a passed. It was an article. Warren article was passed.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and you didn't perform on that one.
Right, so when do we get a chance to talk about that?
I'm part of his budget, though.
Not
so
now.
At what point in our calendar?
Warren article.
I will save that for...
A rainy day?
Review a budget of Warren articles.
Well, that's the Warren article that already passed.
Well,
and so I don't know when
to talk
about it.
Can't do anything for us here with this budget.
Well, probably when I talk to the select.
I don't know. Is it encumbered?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I mean, over $400,000 was taken from the taxpayers to do the work. So I want to know about the status of the work.
We never got
still not part of this budget.
That's fine. I just want to know
when
I can talk about
it. We'll find a place for it.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate that.
We'll find
and
a place.
I will yield the floor at this point.
Thank you very much. Moving on, Bob.
I'll yield the floor.
Hey, salt and sand, we get it from Portsmouth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is what's going to happen if that pile disappears up there?
We have a backup plan. We have a backup
Because aren't they eventually going to do away with the scrap metal pile and that whole area?
I don't know.
In the near future?
I've only heard rumors. I haven't heard any rumors about salt. I know they are having issues with the scrap metal, but I think it's two separate issues.
All right, so we're still safe for a while, right? Okay. All right, I was just curious about that. Thank you.
They signed another one.
Yeah, there's two piles.
I'm not going to give you a tutorial on how to use your manpower. The only question I had was, it seemed like in your discussions, I've heard three, four items when you said you put things out to bid and nobody bid. Is that unique to us here, or is that a phenomenon that's happening everywhere with the economy? People aren't bidding on things?
It's a number of factors. One is the workload right now. Contractors have a lot of work out there. Two is that the town's bidding requirements, like for instance, and I may not have these numbers at the top of my head exactly, but we require, I believe, a $2 million bond. Well, for a contractor to do a contract in Hampton, for a contractor that has a $1,500 potential project in town isn't going to spend, I don't know what a $2 million bond would be, but it's probably, you know, about $600. So if they're only making $1,500, so that's an issue.
Is that unique to us?
Not necessarily. Not necessarily. And then the insurance requirements, too. So I don't want to be critiquing that. That's not really for me to, you know, that's the town selectman's policy. Mm-hmm. But I'm just being straight with you. I have had contractors. We have had contractors say, we'll actually call contractors and try to entice them to bid. Just like the downtown drainage project that we had. Two contractors. And they bid high. They bid twice what we had estimated, because of the problems with dealing with the downtown area and everything. So we have some obstacles that maybe the private sector don't have to deal with. But it's not just exclusive. In the other communities I've worked, we've had the same issues, that contractors, they They think that, you know, and the other thing is that a lot of contractors have had experiences with communities, not just Hampton, where they spend the time and effort in putting into a bid, and then the community decides to reject all the bids because there was only two bidders, or because it was over budget. And so it discourages them because time is money for them. Every minute they spend.
All right.
Just to follow up to Joe's question about Fairfield and Ruth, they've been waiting a long time since the road was tore up. And I know you said it's got to go before the selectmen. My first question is, if it's approved by the selectmen, what time frame do you see? And if it's not approved, what would the time frame be? And what would be the next step?
If it's approved as a warrant article, and that's the plan right now, we'd jump on that right in the early spring, you know, to get that done. We could start putting out a bid for that right after, you know, after the vote. If it's not approved, then, you know, I don't know what to tell you. It's going to have to wait another year for the potential for funding. There would be no other funding available.
You skipped me originally because I was at the men's room. May I ask one question? Thank you. We have everybody working on trash and recycling in the summertime, right?
Not everybody, but we...
I mean, a bunch of people.
Yeah, we have a bunch of people.
Figuratively speaking, we have a lot of people doing that. When does that actually taper off? Because I noticed we're trying to patch in November.
Right after Seafood Festival.
Why can't we do that in September? Is my question.
We are.
We started right after Seafood Festival.
I didn't see any fresh patching anywhere in September. Did you, the roads were all marked off.
Well, we do grinding. It's a two-step process. We have to go out and grind the roads, and then we go out and of course, we got zillions of other things to do as well. You know, roadside mowing. Our guys are really very, very busy.
No argument there, but when...
Right after Seafood Festival, we went down to 9 Nut Ave, replaced, 75 feet of sidewalk down there.
Okay.
Jack hammered it out. We go down to 52 Nud and paved a swale we were supposed to pave a year ago.
Oh, wow.
Then we moved over to some other street we were supposed to pave in the spring. So by the third week of September into October, then the milling machine was out and more active.
Okay. I was just curious. I'm not picking on you.
You're asking a fair question.
We have all the people, a lot of people busy with recycling and so forth in the three summer months. And I was thinking, gosh, we're all the marking everywhere, and I didn't really see any patching until just recently. And I think you won't be able to get any hot top at this time of year. It's getting too cold for it, isn't it?
Yes. Well,
you can buy the hot top. You just putting it down is problematic because of the conditions.
Well, thank you guys for trying. I'm not picking on you at all. I was just curious.
Understood.
Thank you.
Can I ask why the reference to the Seafood Festival?
Because we see a dramatic drop-off of volume right after the Seafood Festival, trash volume. So there's a route shift.
So it's trash-related?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Do I have anything else from anybody else on this?
So, item 3, Municipal Sanitation Wastewater Treatment Administration.
Before,
you have to vote.
Get
it.
We need to vote.
On 4312, right?
Yep.
Right.
On that amount of $440,930.
Mm-hmm.
It was moved, seconded, and discussed.
I can live with this.
All right. All those in favor? That's right. Opposed?
Okay. Keep your hands up. Anybody on this?
And no.
No, we're all pure Dave. Except Dave.
And abstain. Okay. I'm going to give you guys a 5-minute break.
Okay. Oh, please.
Yeah.
Privately.
I know.
Down. I know.
But come back with a little bit of zest and zeal.